we can do one question in exercise number 3.5. The cross multiplication method, that exercise, in that second Roman letter, that we can do first. Okay. Second Roman letter, for which values of A and B does the following pair of linear equations have an infinite number of solutions? The given equations are in this form: 2x plus 3y is equal to 7, a minus b into x plus a plus b into y is equal to 3a plus b minus 2. Question is like this: for which values of a and b, here you can see a, b and all here, instead of the numbers, coefficients are given in terms of a and b, that values of a and b want to find out. For finding that values, it is given, it has, or these equations have infinitely many solutions. If the equations have infinitely many solutions, what is the condition? A1 by A2 is equal to B1 by B2 is equal to C1 by C2. So we are going to find that ratio. Before that, whether the given conditions, the given equations are in standard form or not. So we have to make, these two are not in the standard form. So first you make the standard form. 2x plus 3y minus 7 equal to 0. A minus b into x plus a plus b into y minus of 3a plus b minus 2 is equal to 0. Then that ratios, that condition, these condition we have to write. So 2 by a minus b, a1 by a2, b1 by b2, 3 by a plus b, and c1 by c2 minus 7 by minus of. So, 3a plus b minus 2. These three are equal. So, for finding the values, you can take first two first. First two conditions. First you can take 2 by a minus b equal to 3 by a plus b. Then, cross multiplying. Now, these two fractions are equal means you can take a cross multiplication. You can do 2 into a plus b, that is 2a plus 2b is equal to 3 into a minus b, 3a minus 3b. Then transposing and reducing, you will get answer as minus a plus 5b equal to 0. You make it as an equation number 1 there because you need to sort. Then you take next two conditions, that means the last two fractions, that are two are equal, that we are writing here minus minus, that get cancelled, and 7 by 3a plus b minus 2 we can write there, 3a by 3 by a plus b. Then cross multiplication again, 3 into 3a plus b minus 2, that is 9a plus 3b minus 6, and 7 into a plus b, that is 7a plus 7b, and just again transposing in a simplification after, you can get 2a minus 4b equal to 6. Here two conditions, minus a plus 5b equal to 0, 2a minus 4b equal to 6. We need to solve these two conditions using the elimination or substitution method, any method you can use, and find the value of a and b. Here I used substitution method. From the first equation, 1 implies minus a equal to minus 5b, which implies a is equal to 5b. Negative get cancelled. And substitute the third condition. This is third condition. Substitute in the second. Then we get 2 into 5b minus 4b equal to 6. Then the 10b minus 4b equal to 6. So 6b equal to 6. B is equal to 1. And that b is equal to 1, you can substitute in a third equation, and you can find a is equal to 5. So thus you find here a and b, values of a and b as 1 and 5 and 1. Now we can start our cross multiplication method. How to solve a pair of linear equation using this cross multiplication method. First, our equation will be in the form of a1x plus b1y plus c1 is equal to 0, or a2x plus b2y plus c2 is equal to 0. First step, you have to find whether it is in the standard form or not and make it in the standard form. So, this is, for example, general form is here. Next step, we need to write variables. Here variables are x, y, then constant c1. X, y, constant c2. So, variables which are the variables x and y, and for the place in the place of constant you can write 1. Write x, y and 1, give some space in between. Then we need to arrange. Now we arranged the variable and constant. Then remaining here it is coefficients. Coefficients we have to write here. How to write means this is a form. B, C, A, B. First you have to write B. Then C. Then A. Then B. B means B1, B2. You have to arrange like this. A, X, X, that is first it is variable X, left side, little bit left, you have to write B. B means B1, B2. Then you just want to give some space, and after that you have to write in between X and Y, C. That means C1, C2. Then you have to take some space here in between Y and 1. You have to write A1, A, A1, A2. The last, after that some space here, after 1 you have to write B1, B2. The next step, you have to draw some arrowheads here. First like this, from the left, right, left, top, B1 to C2, then here like this, from bottom to top, again here, again here. Again here, again here. This arrowheads indicates or implies to multiply that. We are going to do this B1 C2, B2 C1 into multiplication product. C1 A2, C2 A1, A1 B2, A2 C1, B1. And you have to subtract. For that one more thing you have to write there. So you have to write here. Three ratios want to form here. First X by, then y by, then 1 by, equal to, in between. X by means below x, b1 c2, arrowheads product. So we have to write b1 c2 minus, subtract you have to do, then next product, what is the next product? B2 c1. Order, it's very important. B1, C2 minus B2, C1. The next you have to take here. This is a pair. C1, A2. C1, A2 minus C2, A1. Next you have to write A1, A1, B2 minus A2, B1. Now we get three equalities or equations or fractions equal, equal fractions. Equating that we can get the values of x and y. Then you can equate 1 and 3. First 2, 3 conditions or last 2 conditions or first and third condition, second and last condition. These are three equalities you can make use and find to find the values of x and y. Just through one example, we can I can explain that. Now we can do one question in exercise number 3.5. Solve using cross multiplication method. The question is like this. 8x plus 5y is equal to 9. 3x plus 2y is equal to 4. First step you have to make in the standard form. That is must here. 8x plus 5y minus 9 equal to 0. 3x plus 2y minus 4 is equal to 0. Next step, we have to write first x, y and 1. Then there we, I told you what, how to write. B, C, A, B. That is a form. So B. B means here B1 and B2. Here B, B means B1, B2. 5, 2. Or here 5, 2. That is B1, B2. Then C1. Standard form you have to look. Standard form minus 9, minus 4. Then again A, B, C, A, A1, A2, that is 8 and 3, 8, 3. Then next B1, B2, again 5 and 2. What is the next step? Put the arrowheads, arrowheads. After that, 5 into B1, C2, that is 5 into minus 4, 5 into minus 4. You write this as in the product as a bracket, inside that bracket numbers you write, in between minus you write, okay. So 5, 4, 5 into 5 into, here it is, 5 into minus 4, 5 into minus 4, then after that, minus 2 into 9, here minus 2 into 9, then 9 into 3, that is minus 9 into 3, minus 4 into 8, then here 8 into 2, minus 3 into 5. Now we'll get x by, there 5 into minus 4, minus 20, minus 2 into 2 into minus 9, plus 18, that is minus 18 plus again or minus sign. Minus into minus become plus 18. The next y by minus 9 into 3, minus 27, and minus 4 into 8, and again one more negative sign. So minus into minus become plus 32. Last term 1 by 8 into 2, 16, minus 3 into 5, 15. Then x by minus 20 plus 18, minus 2. Y by minus 5, simplify. And 1 by 1. Now there, that is equality or fractions reduced like this. Then easy you can find by getting 1 and last. X by minus 2 equal to 1 by 1, which implies x equal to cross multiplying x equal to minus 2. Y by 5 equal to 1 by 1, which implies y is equal to 5.